Hello, today I'm going to show you how to install LibreOffice 6.1 on Ubuntu 80.4. This was released, LibreOffice was released today on the 7th of the 8th of August, I'm not exactly sure. So, it basically just been released and it's a great release. If you want, this will install the default LibreOffice straight from the website, but it's a PPA which you can also add to your system and it will always give you the latest. So we will go to the PPA now that you can have a look at it also, but this will install just LibreOffice 6.1 on your system. That's it. And for many, so this will work on their packages and you can choose your installer and you can see it's quite a lot to choose from. So I'm gonna choose this one, but default the 64-bit version for Ubuntu. This will work on Debian, Linux Mint, Deepin, Sparky Linux, Homini, all the Debian-based distros it will basically work on. So, and the PPA which I mentioned will only work on Ubuntu-based distros. As you can see, it's going to start to download the package soon. My internet should be quite speedy, so it shouldn't take too long, and we can just go to LibreOffice PPA quickly. Just to show you, I'm based in Russia, so that's why it's, I have to choose search by Google, and as you can see, it is the official LibreOffice PPA. As I said, it will only work on Ubuntu based distro. So if you have anything else, don't try this. And it's not yet LibreOffice 6.1. So if you want to get LibreOffice 6.1 today, this method I'm showing you now is the best way to go. So you can just, if you are willing to wait a bit, you can just add this, copy paste this into your terminal, this, and just run normal. You can only copy paste this command because in 18.4 it automatically updates your system after you adding a PPA, which is quite a nice feature, and then normal upgrades if you have already LibreOffice installed. But this is not needed for now because it's not there yet, LibreOffice 6.1, and because it's just been installed, and I'm gonna show you now how to just install LibreOffice 6.1 on any Debian-based distros, and for this video I'm using Ubuntu, but as you can see it's still gonna take a few minutes to download, so I'm gonna fast forward the video now, and I will see you in a bit. Fantastic, as you can see, we just downloaded LibreOffice 6.1, and this is not your normal dev package. If you never installed LibreOffice before from scratch, you will be a bit surprised with this package. So you have to extract it first, or let's extract here. You can remove this package just after the install, and then we click on it. Another click and you will see a package called devs. You double click on and you will see a lot of dev packages. I don't know why they don't make one big one, but they don't. So we right click inside the folder where all these packages is and we say open in terminal. Now we type in sudo, you will find this command inside the description of this video. dpkg -i *, this is shift and a together, .dev, and press enter, type your password, and this will install LibreOffice 6.1. It will install all these packages, all the packages you see here, it will install them all in in one go, which is what you want. So I'm gonna fast forward this part where we install all these packages, and I will see you after this command is finished. Fantastic, as you can see, everything is done. Now, I'm just gonna press on download, and now you can absolutely, if you want to, delete these two packages. If you want to use it for future references and all those things, you can keep it, and now you will have two versions of LibreOffice on your computer. The current one, which you had before, and the new one. So, yeah, so that's quite nice actually in a sense, as you can see they look kind of similar. And if you want to remove the one, you can type in sudo apt remove LibreOffice. I guess it will remove both. And then you can reinstall it if you want to. But if you want to, just keep them both here and see how it works. Fantastic. I'm wondering what one I'm opening up now. Oh, funny. As you can see, this is the one that was pre-installed on my computer. Let's just go for this package. As you can see, it is LibreOffice 6.1, so we got the right one now. And it seems like nothing major has happened, but as you can see, we already got the elementary icons by default. And it's LibreOffice 6.1. And there is some, what they've done in this release, which is really incredible for me, is they added much more layouts, if that makes sense. Basically, let's say, as you can see, it is, let's go to advanced and enable this experimental feature. It's maybe unstable, but it's really not actually, so we can restart now. We can open up LibreOffice, and now you will have many, many user interfaces. So you can have a look at them all. You can go to group bar, and as you can see, here's the menu here. So they got many, let's go to tabbed, and it feels much more, since LibreOffice 6, let's open up LibreOffice 6, I don't know if you will, if it's fine with you or not, but let's do it. I think it's, okay, there was this one. No, what one is what one? Okay, LibreOffice 6, so basically, I wonder if it's both LibreOffice 6 which is opened up. That would be a pity that we can't compare that to, but as you can see, let's have a quick have a look if we can open up. So you can't have LibreOffice 6.0 and 6.1 at the same time. I realized that there was a time not too long ago that somebody mentioned to me that the themes, there isn't any more themes available. Doesn't work, so let's see if we can put in GTK, and then I also tried and it didn't work. So let's see if the Firefox theme selection is actually working again or not, and how does it look with a tabbed version. I'm sure they will fix it again, because it's quite a nice feature if you're not familiar with it. It basically makes you choose what theme, like color theme, you can type in when it worked, dogs or cats or animals or GTK or Qt, and it will just find you nice themes, but it doesn't work yet. It's pretty so. As you can see how it looks now, let's go to just LibreOffice. As you can see, this is LibreOffice 6. And options. And we go to advanced. And just enable. As you can see, we've got only a few options. So it's let's say notebook bar. And massive difference. I'm pretty sure you can agree with me that LibreOffice 6 compared to LibreOffice what the new one, LibreOffice 6 is a major upgrade. View wise, and for many people that is important and that's fantastic. So if you want to get LibreOffice 6.1 now, or you want it with your other one, this is a great way. Otherwise, you can use the PPA. Or you can just remove your current version of LibreOffice and install it like I showed you. Now, yeah, so that's basically that. I think it was a very interesting video and I hope you enjoyed it as much as I have. Please subscribe to this channel. I would love to get to 1,000 subscribers soon. And I will really appreciate it if you like and share and comment. It's wonderful to hear from you. Thank you for watching. See you later. Goodbye.